Hey guys, this is Stephanie Farron, the Technology Facilitator at Butler High School, and this quick video tutorial is how to create and use rubrics in Canvas to grade. So the first thing you need to know is there's two ways you can create and use rubrics. The first thing you need to know is you must create your assignment first. And when I say assignment, it can be any type of assignment, a discussion. Anything but a quiz can have a rubric added to it. So you want to create your assignment first, and then when you save or save and publish your assignment, then in the bottom left-hand corner will be a plus sign for you to add a rubric. So I will show you how to do that. I'm in my sandbox course and I have a sample assignment. It's not a very good assignment. There are no directions, there's no details, but I want to add a rubric to this to show you how to add a rubric. So I'm going to come to the bottom left-hand corner and I'm going to click Add a Rubric. By default, it's going to ask me for a title. The title is Some Rubric. I want to change this so that way once I make this rubric, if I want to use it over and over again on student assignments, I can quickly find it again. And then I'm going to have one criterion up here. I can add many more. To adjust what the description of the criterion is, in the right-hand corner is a pencil. So I'll simply click it. Maybe my first criterion in my rubric is spelling. By default, I have two ratings. If I want more, I'd simply click the plus sign to add another, or as many as I want. Again, I would click the pencil to adjust that. So maybe this one will be full credit. And I can add a description of this, so I could click here and add a longer description of it, looking for correct spelling. And again, this would give the students some more direction. Maybe I'm looking for correct spelling in each of the three introduction paragraphs. Maybe I'm looking for something specific. I can also change the point value. So I can come here and I can do partial credit. And maybe make that 3 points. I can adjust that. One thing to note, you can only do the plus sign up until the last box, so make sure you do it from the beginning to the end, or you can delete these off. So if you make a goof, I'll show you how to fix that. And then no credit. So it's a total of 5 points. I can adjust the point value. If I goof up and I want to get rid of this criterion, I simply click the X. If I have another criterion, I'd click the plus sign and add some more. Maybe the next one I'm going to do is grammar. Okay, so I do each of my criterion. Okay, a couple other things I can do up here. I can choose whether or not I want to free form comments to the students. I normally want to use this rubric when I'm grading. That's really important so that the rubric pops up in my speed grader and all I have to do is click full marks, partial marks, and move on so the students can see my detailed feedback. I can also hide the total score so the students can't see what my assessment results are. I normally use this one, and that way I can grade on this and it automatically calculates what my total score is for my students, and then I can take that total score and send it straight to PowerSchool. So this is essentially like when you used to do presentations in class and you'd hand out a half sheet of paper for each kid and the kid would complete it for each student and then you'd give them an average of the grade. You can do this here. You can also do it with peer reviews and each kid can review each other's work. Once I finish this, I'm going to click Create Rubric, and then it's going to be attached as Sample Rubric, okay? And I'm just going to leave it like that. If I want to use Sample Rubric again, I can find it over and over again, okay? So that's one way to do a rubric. Now, the catch with this one is this rubric goes together. So spelling and grammar go together. It's a total of 10 points. I can do nothing to change this once I save it. Does that make sense? So if I come back to the pencil, I can also find a rubric. Remember, just like when we found outcomes, their rubrics already preloaded into Canvas. So I can come up and look for other rubrics that I've added and then put them back in. Okay, or other rubrics other people have added. So again, if you guys use a lot of rubrics, I'm thinking of fine arts, foreign language, English in the graduation project, you guys probably want to just put one rubric in and then all of you use it together. Okay, so that's how you do rubrics and you attach it. Now, the difference here is that this rubric, the sample rubric, is attached together. Okay, so if in my next assignment I want to use spelling but I don't want to evaluate grammar, I can't use the sample rubric because they're attached together. I'd have to make a change. So I can also make a rubric based on outcomes, and that makes things slightly different. What it does is it allows me to make criterion for spelling, for grammar, and I can track it throughout the entire year, and then I can pop each individual criterion into a rubric. So let me show you what that looks like. So in the Butler Tech Talk page, many of you did my beginning of the year Canvas checklist. And what I did, because I'm going to periodically throughout the year check back in on you all and see where you are, is I made a rubric, which I graded on. Those of you who have submitted it, you've seen my rubric feedback, and I'll show you what it looks like in SpeedGrader in a minute. But what I did is I attached them to outcomes. So again, I clicked the plus sign to add the rubric, okay? But when I added it, I added outcomes that I had created. You can tell because they look like little bullets, okay, or a bullseye. And the reason why I did it is next time, maybe I want to look for your biography, but I also want to look for your homepage, but not the other three items. This will allow me to manipulate my rubric and change it anytime by just deleting one of the criterion. So I might use 5 criterion this time, 10 the next time, 4 the next time, and I can use that same individual criterion and not have to rewrite a rubric. So that's how that works. Let me show you what it looks like, and then I'll show you how to fix the outcomes. So now I'm in the same assignment. I clicked SpeedGrader. I've hidden the student names to prevent their anonymousness. And then I'm going to grade it. So if I was going to grade this, I would actually click it so I could see their work, but I'm not because I'll give it away who it is. I'll click View Rubric. My rubric will pop up. I can adjust the side of this so I can see it. And then simply when I'm grading, I just simply click the ones that match the student work. If I want to give the student feedback, I can click the little word bubble and then give that student individual feedback. Or I can still come down at the bottom and make an assignment comment. And again, my assignment comment can be words, they can be audio, or video, or both. So I can give really individualized feedback. When I click save for this student, then their grade automatically pops up based on my criterion. And then I just simply click the send to SIS, and that grade will go to PowerSchool. So this makes a lot more organizational sense, especially if I'm grading something rubric-wise with a student. So I'm going to come back in real quick and delete the information since I haven't graded the student work. So what I did to create that rubric is I clicked on outcomes, and then I'm going to create some outcomes. What I did was I actually made a folder, okay, so I put them in a group. Since I'm going to be evaluating different Canvas elements that my teachers and students are using throughout the year. So when I open my Canvas elements, you can see what things I've checked on. So one of them was biography. So I click on biography, this is what I had. I had under the Canvas account setting, they had created a biography, they have one link and information about you. If you notice, what I did for this is I had the latest score and by points. So I'll show you how to add that. I'd simply click add another outcome. Again, the title of the outcome be whatever I'm measuring or whatever I want it to see in the rubric. So maybe, like I said before, as my previous example, spelling. The friendly name is normally what your students would see. The description is what you're looking for. Did you spell your words correctly? As I spell words incorrectly. And then the catch down here is, by default, decaying average is what you use whenever you're putting outcomes and attaching them to quizzes, because it's based on the highest score and then an average. But if we're doing a rubric, we probably don't want a decaying average. We want either a number of times, most, or most recent score. And you can put mastery at whatever. So if you're going to make this a 10-point part of the rubric, then mastery might be at 9, or mastery might be at 8. Whatever you think is the threshold that would equivalent it to 60% or higher in your class. And you'll click save. Remember that just like with any other outcome, you can only delete outcomes if they've not been attached to something. So for example, if I go back and click biography, I'm not going to be able to delete it anymore because I've attached it to an assignment. So the spelling one, because I haven't attached it to anything, I can delete it, but I can't delete the biography one. I still can go in and edit it. This is sometimes annoying for you as a teacher, but remember, students can't see inside of outcomes. They can only see it in Mastery Pass, so it won't even show up if you're not using it. So I'm going to come back and delete spelling. Then, when I'm in an assignment, I can actually click any of these items, which will change the total number of points in my assignment. So each time, if I'm going to use this over and over again, say for example, graduation project and looking to see if they made their changes each time, I can use different parts of my rubric over and over again. So it's kind of just a decision in your teaching, if you're going to use different parts of a rubric over and over again in different assignments, or if you're going to use one rubric over over and over again as to which one you'll choose to use. So try using Rubrics, see what you think. I particularly love them in the speed grader because they're so quick and easy to complete student work and to give meaningful feedback.